back to my class. You know that I'm Halim Nisa, teacher and junior lecturer of Elizabeth High School and Junior College. So in today's class, we are discussing about the 11th chapter, which is related to our civics subject, second year. And chapter name is Smart Governance. Here, according to the Oxford Dictionary, governance is an act or a manner of governing the office of a state. Whereas, according to the Haydn, here the governance is a stewardship of a formal and informal political rules of the game. And here the governance refers to those measures that involve the setting the rules for the exercise of power and setting the conflicts over such rules. Exactly. Here the meaning of governance is that governance means to design the formulate and implement the policies and discharge the functions. So they are the rules of the political system to solve the conflicts between the actor and adopt the decisions by the class communities and the various sections. Sometimes here the institutions like lobbies and the political parties and the media, civil society and the legislature and executive and the judiciary influence the decision making. Exactly. So they can be referred to as a stakeholders. Here the stakeholders in governance are executive, legislature, judiciary, media, private sector, social organization, civil society and political parties. So after this stakeholders, now we will see about the smart governance here. Here smart stands for simple, moral, accountable, responsive and transparent. Get it? That is smart. And here the components of smart governance is that to prove the performance of the administration and to enhance the accountability and transparency and to do away with a petty politics and successful the implementations of the public policy and the greater efficiency and the role of community leadership, etc. will become under the components of smart governance. Now we will see about the good governance here. Here the good governance can be defined as the governance associated with efficient and effective administration with a democratic framework. So here the definition on good governance includes the active participation of the people in governance through the national, state, local government agencies. So here according to the UNO, the following are the characteristics of the good governance here. So see this one. Now here after the characteristics of the good governance, now we will see the initiatives of good governance in India, and that are the enactment of RTI Act 2005 and reforms in civil services and Aadhaar card and citizen character and recommendations of the 6th Pay Commission and the administrative reforms and national e-governance plans. So all these are the initiatives of a good governance in India. Now we will see about the e-governance. E-governance means here the electronic governance. It can also be called as the paperless governance. Here under this, the governance functions on the basis of utilization of information technology. So this will enhance the efficiency and effectiveness of the services. So here internet and other web-based telecommunications and technologies are used. Speed and accuracy are the other additional features. Here the group, institutions and the citizens enjoy the quality and the continuous services. So here the e-governance shows the transparency, efficiency and accountability. It is participated in the state of Chhattisgarh by 2017 and it will move towards as a paperless administration. Get it? So here some are the models of e-governance, and like government to citizen, that is G to C, and government to business, that is G to B, and government to government, that is G to G, and government to employees, that is G to E. So after the E governance, now we will see about a Right to Information Act 2005. Here in this, the Right to Information Act 2005 received the presidential assent on the 15th June in 2005 and become the fully operational by October 2005. Here the act applies to all the states and union territories except the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which is dealt separately. So here every citizen has a right to access the information, since all the information held by the government ultimately belongs to the public. Exactly. So this act recognized the sharing of the information by government with the citizens as a healthy and beneficial to the functioning of democracy. Exactly. So here lastly, information leads to the new awareness and the empowerment. So here the submission of pleas under the RTI Act 2005. So see this one. After observing the channels of RTI Act 2005, now we will see about the transparency and accountability. Here first we will see the transparency here. Transparency refers to a free and unfettered access by the public to timely and reliable information on decision and performance of the government in various sectors. So it includes timely, accessible and accurate information. This information given is easy to estimate even by a layman. So here the rules and regulations, it can be attained. So here it is an important component in good governance practices. Exactly. And here the social audit ensures the transparency in the process of administration and decision making. So here the transparency make efficiency in the administration by the streamlining of services delivery system and recommended social audit to reduce the corruption and deviation and the malpractices also. So after this, now accountability. Here accountability means the official are accountable for their decisions and actions to the public. So they are subjected to public. In a wider sense, it includes the bodies and the civil society organizations and the stakeholders and the organizations as well. The rule of law and the transparency can ensure the accountability here. Get it? So after this, now the idea of smart cities. Here, after discussing the smart governance, it is important to refer the idea of smart cities. Exactly. So here the idea of smart cities has been formulated by the government of India. So in recent times, here the smart cities become a catchphrase in the political vocabulary of India among the various political parties and elected the representatives. So here relatively it is a recent phenomena in government sector to improve the governance services through the intervention of technology and the smart solutions. So here in Indian municipalities, here the smartness is beyond the e-governance. So under the national e-governance plan, here the 2.0, it was proposed to create the 100 smart cities by the union government. Due to the rapid urbanization, growing the population and the migration, it has become an important task before the government. So here the new proposals regarding the urban affairs were discussed. Here meaning of the smart city means a smart city is well organized and planned city. It contains the wide range of facilities and the catering to the needs of the citizens and the industrialists and the tourists and the foreign investors and the disabled and the old people also. So here a smart city has centers of communities with all the amenities. Get it? So here the smart city is a mix of smart infrastructure and smart government also. For example, GIFT. Here, GIFT means here the Gujarat International Finance and Technology City. Get it? So here are some of the objectives of smart city, like the extensive use of information and communication technology and social capital, and like the sustainable economic development and high standard of living for every citizen, and the participatory action, and here the engagement between the citizen and the authorities, and also the skill development and sound management of national resources, and smart infrastructure and smart government, and to enhance the quality of life for the citizen, and to strengthen the urban local governance here. So by these objectives of smart governance, we have completed our 11th chapter, that is smart governance. Thank you.